Hello, everybody. Welcome back here to game number two between VG.P and Newbee Miracle. I got held up a second there. I was thinking, hang on, VG against Newbee? No. The second team of VG Gaming and the third team of Newbee here battling up in the VPGame qualifiers to try and get themselves into that main event and play against the big teams. Play against, you know, eHome, CDEC are up there as well, HGT, the actual tier one Chinese teams. Let's head over to the draft, see what we're dealing with here and whether VGP can make this a 2-0 sweep or, you know, can Miracle actually get a win under their belt? What do you think, Scant? Can Miracle bring it back in this game?
It's possible. I favor VGP to take a 2-0. I just feel bad because if that happens, then Miracle will be on the receiving end of the only 2-2-0s in the whole tournament.
Yeah, and that pretty much puts them out of contention for qualification, really.
Yeah, so, but they stick to their guns. They go for that SF again, just like last game. And Lion. HGK had a rough start to the game, but pulled out some plays later on. Fast fingers on the Shadow Razors, nice plan with the Requiem as the enemy team approached the high ground. So we'll see. Maybe we have a different game. The Triple S's Queen of Pain was banned out in the first phase this time. So
yes, it was.
I guess Storm Spirit for him instead this time.
Yeah, it's possible. Could be Storm Spirit safely in all mid. You're never quite sure. The mid has come back into fashion, though, after that short stint in this safe lane from a lot of European teams. Axe ban out there from VGP as they take out the Troll and Batrider in the first 1-2. Now, Treant. There are so many heroes that, you know, really benefit heavily from having a Treant on your team. Phoenix is obviously one of the biggest one. You put out Fiery Spirits, you dive back and forth, and Treant just living arms you back up to full health. So I'm a little bit surprised that Newbee Miracle don't ban out the Phoenix here, but maybe they just don't feel it's a threat right now.
Witch Doctor ulti goes pretty well with Treant ulti as well. There's still the sniper in the pool, which goes really well with the Treant. Storm Spirit gets protected well by the Treant too. There's a lot of things to combine with that hero.
Oh man, there's still Sniper in the pool. What the hell's going on? How has Sniper made it all the way through here? Although last night in the MSI Dragon Battle, I did see Axe make it all the way through to the 5th pick. He wasn't banned or picked at all until like the very... it's like the 10th pick actually, you know, the final pick of the actual draft. Sometimes, you know, teams are just so focused on their draft and what they need and what's good against them that you kind of just forget about these popular meta heroes, or you don't care too much about them because there are other heroes that are more important to you to be banned out or picked. Now, Newbee Miracle,
yeah.
SF Lion, and one more.
I mean, it's not necessarily a problem, right? I think that's a totally legitimate line of thought that we've got a plan, they've got a plan, we're drafting around our plan and their plan, and so what if there's a hero that people normally pick, if it's not related to what's going on in this draft? You know, I think it's quite reasonable to ignore those kinds of things. It's just, to me, it's strange to see a hero like Sniper not being picked right at the start of a draft when it's not banned, because of some of the performances we've seen by it. I mean, yesterday Alliance was just having Sniper first phase banned against them all the time because of how well Pycat's been doing on it. And maybe that's what it has to do with. Maybe these particular teams have scrimmed each other, know that each other don't one another don't really run the sniper that much, and so aren't that concerned about it. And, you know, might consider it later on, but don't feel the need to prioritize it.
I think it feels like a better pick here for VGP. You know, put the Storm Sprint safe and have then the Sniper against Shadow Fiend mid, Living Armor, and then Witch Doctor to roam in with a cast. You can find pretty easy kills on the SF, and Miracle don't have a way to respond to that right now. Bristleback is not a roaming offlaner. He can't go and make kills towards mid early on in the game at all. He wants to sit there, farm, stack up Ancients, maybe dip back into the jungle, but his main role is to annoy the hell out of support. So that's what he's going to be looking at doing there. But Newbee Miracle, if they pick up a Sniper against a Storm Spirit mid, you know, it's potentially very good. But then once Storm hits 6, that's where things start to turn around. So I can see Newbee Miracle sort of ignoring the hero for themselves. 5th ban would be pretty good, though.
Yeah. I think I agree with that, too.
So VGP
but we'll see. I mean, if VGP really wants it, they'd probably take it now.
Yeah,
I don't see why they'd have to wait till 5th.
Yeah, exactly. Their 4th pick, so we've got Storm Spirit, that core hero, they've got the 2 supports. Picking your mid now, you pretty much know for certain Shadow Fiend's heading that way. He has been played in the one roll up in the safe lane now and then, but The main power spike of him is, you know, once he hits that level 3 in the laning phase is one of them, but it's level 5. And then you go back into the jungle, you farm up camps, you get yourself into treads, ring of aqua, bottles, and get yourself towards that mech by sort of 11 minutes. Or the Yules, whichever route you go for. The insta-kill potential on Storm is pretty good. Make sure that he doesn't get armored up by the Treant and take him down with a level 2 Requiem. Spirit Breaker is the pick there from VG.P. Interesting.
Yeah, and Spirit Breaker here that we saw banned a lot yesterday in the other series in this tournament. And it seems like an offlaner that the Tier 2 Chinese teams don't like playing against. But normally we see it picked up with a lot more aggressive picks. I mean, these picks could get aggressive, but they don't really start that way. I suppose the Treant can armor the Spirit Breaker when he dives in. But until the Storm's level 6, he's not going to be able to help him make kills. And Witch Doctor and Treant's not really that mobile in terms of helping the Spirit Breaker make kills.
Kind of makes me wonder if they will go back for that that Invoker. Because Secret played Exalt Invoker the other day, didn't he? It was Exalt, right?
Yes, I think it was, yes.
Because he was throwing out Sunstrikes, and they did have the setup for it. Here with Spirit Breaker Charge, that's a decent setup. You can preempt just before the Spirit Breaker hits the charge to try and land that Sunstrike down. Now, Miracle with the Sand King, a little bit passive on their side. They've got Sand King and Shadow Fiend, who both want to farm the jungle. Bristleback, looks like VGP expect him to be in the one-roll carry, actually, with a lion supporting him. Broodmother banned out, and they do not have any heroes to deal with it at all. Storm Spirit, no, he gets screwed over by Broodmother royally in the laning phase. Witch Doctor and Treant don't have any clearing abilities and Spirit Breaker. It's going to be an annoyance for him. So VGP would really have to focus a fifth pick on dealing with it. And with Bristleback, Axe all gone, picking up a Tide here isn't really a possibility. So that's a really solid ban.
Yeah, it's a very important area to ban when you know that you're not going to be able to deal with it. And the Lycan ban in response from Newbee Miracle, which I guess could have pulled this whole draft together as like a group up and be aggressive and push and dive kind of strategy.
Well, so far, Newbee. Oh! Where, safe lane Doom?
It's gotta be, right? Where else could it be? Unless they do the safe lane Spirit Breaker off lane Doom, but I don't see the purpose in that. Safe lane Doom, yeah, Doomringer here that was super popular in China and lost popularity for a while, but it's one that you sort of feel inevitably will make a comeback. I think that some of the Tier 1 teams have ran it here and there. I think I saw Newbee run it once or twice, and I'm not sure. I think EHOME played it. I think ROTK played it once for EHOME. But it hasn't come back to that dominant presence it had before, not just yet.
Oh yeah, we used to see, you know, Siler, and back in Dota 1, it was the hero to pick up. It outfarmed everyone, you got these big items, and you just ran at people with your ultimate. But nowadays, it feels like it slots into offlane or role 4 a lot more naturally. Now you have a greedier support. Doom jungling isn't too bad at all. You've got the Devourer, you go through the jungle, and you take down camps, and you can make gangs early on if you get the right creeps. But you can also farm pretty damn efficiently. Here, though, it looks like it's going to be that safe lane farming Doom. I'm just wondering where the supports go. Because stacking and pulling, sure, you're going to build up stacks for the Storm Spirit, and he's the only real person that can go in there to take them down. How does Spirit Breaker build up farm? What's his role? Because you mentioned it when he was picked up. He's an aggressive hero. He likes to give that vision and find the openings for, you know, Storm to zip in or someone to land that skill shot. Who is that someone? There isn't one.
Well, I can say, I mean, he can try and go on the SF at the stage that SF's farming somewhere and combine with just about anyone who's laning against SF. But the last time we saw Yang do the offlane Spirit Break, he actually got a fairly fast Midas, and that's all he kept up.
Oh yeah, that's very true. Very true indeed. Let's have a look at these teams, though. Dogfights on the tree, and Yang playing the Spirit Breaker. James, a Witch Doctor. And they're all running down towards this mid lane. Smoke has been picked up. Are they going to go through into the dire jungle here? This is the path you take when you do that. But they've got Triple S on the Storm Spirit, Secret on the Doom. Where are they going? Both teams, they both bought smokes, but neither of them has used it yet.
Well, Boots first Treant's pretty good for a fight. Charge, paralyzing casks. Storm Spirit's not going to do much in early fights unless he actually gets onto someone with Remnant. Doombringer, if he takes the Scorched Earth, could be really strong in a fight.
Well, if you look at the sort of right-click physical attack damage, The Radiant have a massive advantage. With Witch Doctor 56 base, the 61 from Triple S with the Null Talisman, 61 from the Doombringer, Newbee Miracle, they've got Shadowfiend who does sod all, like 48, 49. Oh, here we go, start off, double barrel strike, but it's not going to do too much. AGK, I don't know, you're going to take Razors or something here. The great stun out from Lion, but the first to fall is the Sand King. Razors, AGK, ripping through the life totals of Newbee Miracle, but Cold Snap, the Bristleback, is the one who's dropping lower. Yang dies, the Doombringer with Scorched Earth will finally bring down the Bristleback. So far, what the hell is going on? 2 for 2 and a 3 for 2 as Newbee Miracle take down 3, losing first blood, but that's a pretty crushing defeat. The Earth Spike and the Bar Strike landing on multiple heroes multiple times, just proving to be that one big difference maker.
Yeah, having the stuns ends up mattering more than having the right clicks. And also the fact that Shadowfiend decided to take his level 1 Shadow Rays to hit a bunch of nuke damage there. Which is not all we'd have expected him to do, I think, in this lane, but definitely helped out in that fight. Might affect his lane a bit negatively now, because he comes to lane with level 1 Shadow Rays and no mana.
Cold Snap, the Bristleback, he saw the Witch Doctor and thought, hey look at this guy, we pretty much screwed them over in the jungle, let's go and take another kill. Went up to James and spammed out some cool sprays, but then dogfights with the boots, chased him down the little bit of the 5 movement speed advantage, and the fact you're dealing with 85, you know, is it 81? Yeah, 81 to 89 base damage just thwacking you in the face. Bristleback level 1 without his passive, he still takes a lot of damage.
Yeah, in this mid lane, Shadowfiend suffering just a little bit. It's going to take a while to get his bottle up. He actually just sent himself a healing salve. But he's not that far behind. And I think once he gets a couple of souls, it'll even out quite a lot.
Storm is level 3. He's actually half a level ahead. Who got the bounty runes? That's something that I didn't actually see. Okay, yeah, that's why. That's exactly why. Storm Spirit picks up the bounty rune while down on bot. The Bristleback found his. Cold Snap is still getting chased around though. Dogfights with his Treant is making his life a living hell. Treant level 2 with a level 1 Bristleback who is 5 experience away from that point.
It's important for dogfights to do this because the Witch Doctor can't really. The Bristleback can actually abuse the Witch Doctor. Even though the Witch Doctor has high base damage, he's just too squishy. But the Treant can zone the Bristleback for days.
Indeed, indeed, indeed. For those of you just joining us, this is game number 2 here in this 2-game series between Newbee Miracle and VG Potential in the VP game Groupstage qualifiers for their main event. VG.P Secret down on the spot lane playing the one roll Doom with Dogfights Treant supporting him. James, Witch Doctor, Yang is actually fighting up against 5400's Lion here up on top lane. And he's going to do a decent amount of damage. I don't think he wants to expend charge. And they've got, what, the same? Yeah, and they've got exactly the same movement speed, so there's no way really to close the gap against some more right clicks in there. We have Anti-Mage on top. I'm not sure what his name is, and I'm probably never going to find out. Then you've got Sand King, who's going to be stacking, pulling, trying to build up his experience in gold as much as he can. AGK, Shadowfiend for the second time at this mid lane.
With a 3-3 score, if Vinci Gang Potential get 19 kills with 0 deaths, we'll get to that 3-2-2. I don't know if that's likely at this point, but... Oh wait, no, yeah, other way around.
Newbee.M have to get it.
Oh, but that's a lot less likely, isn't it?
Yes. that's what I thought you were saying. Oh, I misheard you the first... I thought you said it right the first time. I was like, yeah, it's really not likely at all. The chance of that happening is close to nil, but we'll see. We'll see. Newbee Miracle, you know, they've got the Sand King farming the jungle if he gets a quick blink. 5400 Lion, they've got plenty of mobility and disables, and we're still yet to see what VGP's overall game plan here is, what the actual teamfight cohesion is going to be like, whether they can... Okay, well, they can kill the Bristleback over in the end with Maledict up and a couple of right clicks. Bristle looks like he went to contest this pull through, not quite getting what he expected, though. Yang on top lane, no mana for charge. He's getting right click down and 5400 with an Earth Spike. They'll find a kill on the opposing offlaner as well.
Does the... I suppose Secret's Doombringer goes Aghanims this game, right? Given that previous change about needing the Aghanims to disable passives, because it's really good against both the Anti-Mage and the Bristleback, I think. So that's probably an item that he ends up picking up, maybe after Midas, but I think he needs to go for it. And then the idea will be for any combination of two heroes between Spirit Breaker, Doombringer, and Storm Spirits. just be constantly making kills. What lane Cold Snap? Is he gonna go down again?
They've got the leech seed in. Yeah, Cold Snap is gonna fall. I wish Doctor does die first of the cross spray getting spammed out, but Maledict is that gonna tick him over? It's gonna be close. Oh man.
Three. Level 1 Maledict. If it was level 2, he's dead.
3 hit points. 3 freaking hit points.
And Bristleback showing why it's a good hero there. Stacking up those cool sprays. Getting 1 kill, nearly getting 2. And getting out alive.
Pretty damn close. Pretty damn close. How does Doom actually work with Necromastery? Because that's a passive as well, but it's an odd one. Does it stop that? Doom Aghanim's on Shadow Fiend.
I really doubt that it does.
Time to find out. Dota 2 wiki time. Yeah. Yang is in the middle of the jungle here. Sand King and Lion are both ready. Hex and stuns? No? Not going to go for it. I guess with Storm Sprint moving his way up, he's got limited mana, but the DD rune in the bottle is definitely a deterrent for them. Looking around, poking his head over that ramp, but they're not going to go in here. They do have a support in the Witch Doctor heading into this top into this mid lane. A Spearbreaker has left his lane and is now 1,000 gold away from his Midas.
This Doombringer's helmet, actually. It looks so weird to me. Look on his portrait. It looks like his head's being squashed.
There was one of the funniest pictures I've seen. Oh, but we're going to wait until AGK charged up here. Storm jumps in, but the Burst Strike onto the Storm will put him under the tower. Sam Storm now down onto him as Yang. They will find the kill on the Shadow Fiend with the help of that DD rune from Triple S. And Anti-Mage, what are you doing? Triple S doesn't have that much mana to actually turn back into damage. And he'll just have to back himself up, wasting time moving to the mid lane looking for a counter kill, but not getting it. But yeah, the Doombringer face, you know the pictures of just kill me when there's someone like really really ugly or really sad looking is like just finish me off now. There's one of the Doombringer with his 8 eyes. He looks really sort of despondent and he's an abomination. He doesn't look like a Doombringer really. Whoa. Whoa, hang on, how does that happen? AM getting taken down by the Storm Spirit up on the top rune spot.
I am not sure.
Are you having any luck with the with Aghanim's Doom?
Yeah, it doesn't look like it disables Necromastery, and actually just a reminder, we've spoken about this before, but I think I wasn't clear about it before. For the Bristleback, it only disables the
block.
The actual Quill Spray.
Oh, sorry, not the block, yeah.
Yeah, not the block.
It's the same with Hex. Yang, speaking of, gets Hexed up himself and double raises. No, the second one misses. Right clicks will be enough to finish him off, though. Yeah, it's just one of those confusing little things that it's a passive. Why doesn't it block the entirety of the passive?
Yeah, there's no explanation. What we're told by Dota 2 Wiki is that it works as a mute, and then there's like a list of things that mutes disable. I'm not sure.
It does some weird stuff. But back into this game. 4k net worth up on the Doombringer right now with 3400 on the Storm Spirit. Anti-Mage is lagging behind a little bit. And he's charged up on this top lane. But it's just Spirit Breaker wanting to get a free ride back up to top. Last hit wise, we're looking at 48 on the Doom, 39 on the Storm. Even though the AM is, you know, up there with the Storm Spirit, his one death really has hurt him a lot. And the Storm Spirit's 103. Kill assist to give you a whole bunch of gold, a lot of experience, and hero levels 8 and 8. Shadow Fiend and Storm Spirit 7 and 7 on the Doom and AM. But then you're kind of looking at a Spirit Breaker who's a little bit far behind the Bristleback. Sure, he's close to level 6, and Bristleback's halfway through his. But the supports. You're nearly level 6 on the Witch Doctor and the Treant. The Lion is getting close, but the Sand King really needs to step up his game. Level 2 Sandstorm now.
Look at this. This could be a delicious paralyzing cask. Is he going to go for it? Oh, the Shadow Fiend and Lion were isolated for a while. But actually, there's an Observer Ward for the die that spotted out the Witch Doctor and Treant heading to the jungle. So everyone kind of knows that something's up and everyone just backs off.
Yes, indeed. Sand King has moved towards his mid lane. Giving over the jungle to the Shadow Fiend, in fact. So his Blink Dagger is just going to get delayed and delayed further and further. It's really something you need here to defend Tau. Secret is headed back into the jungle. He's got a couple of stacks for himself. And with that Midas, his farm rate's going to just amplify. With a stack taken. Whoa. Lion insta-killed by the jump in from Triple S, and this tier 1 tower should get taken out by the double damage rune.
Dota 2 Wiki also says that Doom won't disable Anti-Mage's spell shield, which I thought it would. It does disable Mana Break, which is still very relevant, but...
Storm jumps in with the Death Ward, the Fire the Sand King here, one more, no? Three, again, 3 HP! 3 is meant to be the number that doesn't exist for Valve or Dota 2, but or Half-Life, but in fact in this game, Triple S invised up and under the tower is meaningless. Twice though, Newbee Miracle have heroes that escape on 3 hit points as 5400 is charged up by Yang, gets hit in the face by a bash, but won't find a kill.
And Lion's got level 6 now, thanks to being around that Storm Spirit kill. And you might want to use it on this Witch Doctor soon. I think one Shatter Ace and a Finger of Death will probably kill that Witch Doctor.
But the Lion's hiding in the jungle. He wants his Blink Dagger. He's 1700 gold away from it. He'll probably stack up this camp and try and pull it through. Anti-Mage needs some prep time for his farming. And you have 4 heroes that need to abuse the jungle. Bristleback, okay, he can take the Ancients, which he's already done so, actually. A couple of stacks have been done by him. Sand King and Shadow Fiend need the jungle. Anti-Mage, sure, in about 10 minutes' time, once he's got that Battle Fury, he'll take that down. Yang, mana burned. Hex before he can charge. Can they drop his mana low enough? Yep, there we go. With a mana void, finishing him off, but no charge out. Great play there by 5400 and the Anti-Mage, just finding the Spirit Breaker before he could react.
Yeah, and Yang's still trying to rush out that Midas, but all these deaths really slowing it down. And the dynamic between a Storm Spirit and an Anti-Mage when they match each other up, it's normally that Anti-Mage is actually weak against Storm because Storm is a hero that can shut him down early on. But if the Storm himself is being a bit shut down, I mean, after that death in the mid lane, I don't know. I said a few times, I think combination of Storm and Doom, or Doom and Spirit Breaker, or Storm and Spirit Breaker could definitely gang the Anti-Mage. But once he gets to Battle Fury and starts picking up item after item after item, then he becomes the counter to the Storm, and certainly not the other way around.
Yeah, and regardless of whether the Storm is behind or ahead, the Storm's going to be expending a whole bunch of mana in these teamfights. Chasing the Sand King and the AM with Blinks and Burrow Strikes, the Bristleback is pretty quick on his feet as well, so he's going to be zipping around and really running through that mana pretty quickly. So the fact that he's burning through that pool and the Mana Void is being leveled up will hit level 2 shortly. Maledict though, and the Death Ward, it's Overgrowth, a great combination as Storm zips in. Witch Doctor secures the kill, and James is now on a killing spree.
Oh, yeah. Yang's gonna die again at the bot lane.
Oh no, he moved down here for safe farming time. Secret left him alone for 2 seconds, and in comes the support. Lion with the Finger of Death, and Cold Snap slowing him down with that Nasal Goo.
I wonder if they know that Yang likes to go for Midas and Spirit Breaker, and they're like, well, if that's your plan as a Spirit Breaker, we're just going to keep you down, keep you down, keep you down, and by the time you finally get it, you're just not going to be very effective on the map.
Cold Snap. He's going for the mech build this game, so no Vanguard straight up for him. And that kind of puts Shadow Fiend into Yules, yeah. Staff of Wizardry for him, so they'll go for the aggressive play with the SF just to try and, you know, insta-kill the Storm or someone like that. Cold Snap top lane, Doom! Maledict and the zip in from Triple S. They'll find this kill pretty easily as HGK. What's the counter? With Bow Strike, he'll get it. The two razors really well timed and positioned as the Requiem will pop, slowing down
what?
Secret. But it looks like Sand King screwed up the epicenter.
Yeah, he just cancelled it. Nothing cancelled. It was just him.
Misclick. But Storm's dead. Dogfights falls. And now Secret's the last one standing. They go in and they get a kill on the Bristleback. But the reaction coming in, the TPs and movement of Newbee Miracle. Finding it 3 kills for 1.
You know what happened there, I think, with the Sand King? He saw the Doombringer running away, and so he desperately didn't want to waste any time. He wanted to run as soon as Epicenter finished channeling, and just right-click slightly too soon. Because the Doom was running with Scorched Earth, might have actually gotten away. But it doesn't actually matter, because even without the Epicenter, his team won the fight.
Yeah, got themselves a Yules on the SF, Blink on the Sand King, which I thought would be a lot more delayed, but with that one fight, it's gone from sort of being a 15-minute Blink Dagger into a 13.5 one, so... Epicenter's on cooldown, not the most optimal timing, but he'll look to defend towers. They've still got 3 tier 1 standing, which I think is the great thing here for Newbee Miracle. The fact that tier 1s haven't fallen, they've got a pretty decent team at reacting and TPing in to try and counteract any pushes in from VG.P, sure? Taking towers of their own is going to be hard as well, with Living Armor being thrown out by the Treant, and they've got no natural pushing hero. They've got Split Push from the AM once he reaches Battle Fury and Vlad's, or or the Yasha. We'll see which way he goes. Sand King is pretty good at pushing out lanes as well with the level 3 Sandstorm. But when it comes to objectives and tower taking, it's kind of just going to be a war of attrition. VG.P want the solo pickoff. They want to jump in and initiate. newb.m kind of want to do the same thing, but it's going to come down to a numbers game. Whether or not VG.P have 5 up against 4 with the anti-mage missing, Cold Snap, doomed up. Yang goes for the Nether Strike and will push him back into secret. Right click attack is coming through, but the support coming in. Burst Strike catches both of them as Lion. Earth Spike not going to hit Yang. The Finger of Death will, though. His secret is hexed up, mana drained. Sentry's placed and he turns to fight. Death Ward with a Malignant. Sand King drops and that's a 1-for-1. Luckily for Yang, he's had his Midas for a while and he's not too worried about this.
Yeah, support for Flynn. I think he's just more worried about the fact that, you know, he's 1-for-6. He's not had the impact he wanted yet. Sure, he's got his Midas. Sure, he's gonna like be able to keep up a bit with the farm, but he wanted that to all be like 5 minutes ago kind of thing. And Spirit Breaker wants to be in a position where he can quite aggressively and bravely charge into things. And right now, the Spirit Breaker is not in that position. He only has 1,000 HP. He's super tanky at the start of the game, but he has not scaled at all in terms of tankiness.
No, and with the really great early lead that VG.P had, about a 2,000 to 3,000 net worth lead at 7 or 8 minutes in, that has been slowly but surely whittled away by newb.m. With these fights that they're taking, they're trading evenly or better. They're out farming with the jungle efficiency they've got.
Dead.
Oh boy.
Lion is just dead.
He is, yeah, he's screwed. The Hex out onto Triple S will slow it down, but he's got no mana. He's got no actual cooldowns left to throw out either, so quick and easy one there. But giving his life for 3 heroes moving in, he's created space for Bristleback to farm and stack ancients. The Antimage has Battle Fury and is farming the jungle. That death doesn't really mean too much.
Yeah, on the one hand, going into the offlane alone on the lion is basically asking to die in this game, but on the other hand, you're right, if it's not the Antimage who's dying, if it's not the Bristleback who's dying, it's not really good enough, actually, for VG.Gang potential.
And there you go with the Blink Dagger for the Shadow Fiend. AGK now has the defensive and offensive capabilities of Yule's Blink. Go for the insta-kill on someone like Storm Spirit, or go for the Yules and blink out if you do get jumped on. So he's going to be a lot harder to kill right now. And with the 3 blinks they've got, Lion is getting closer to his. newb.m are actually looking in good stead to take this game. Sure, Aghanim's is done on the Doom and they're smoking themselves up. They're going to make the most of this one. And they want to try and find the AM in the jungle. Can they find him though? Yang has the charge and Nether Strike. They've got no vision really over on the east side. They've got an Observer Ward here spotting movement between Large Camp and River. But newb.m hiding in the trees. Sand King's ready for this, waiting for someone to farm this lane. They've got the Lion watching for aggressive Observer Wards behind the tower, which is pretty well thought out from him.
But Bristleback and Shadow Fiend might run into Bristleback's gonna run into
them. Yeah, they'll find him.
Doombringer's got Aghanim's.
They'll get the charge down. Doom is needed here. They'll get another strike, but in comes the HGK Shadow Fiend. Requiem across all of them. Slows them down. Debuffs as well as they find 2-for-1 again. The exchange, not what they wanted. Dogfights, that's a 3rd-to-4 in secret. What's your escape plan? What's your way out? It looks like it's the grave. A secret is going to get raised and burst strikes in about 2 seconds' time. Can he land the double? Triple S was starting to position himself behind the Doom. But it looks like 4-for-1 in the end, and it's just getting to the point where VG.P can't take these teamfights. They're looking for pickoffs, but newb.m are positioning and reacting so well to VG.P's smokes and gangs and everything that it's nigh impossible to win a teamfight.
VG.P dumping, newb.m dumping everything on the Bristleback there. I want to say that the Bristleback could have died without the Doom. If the Doom's still up as the SF blinks in and SF gets doomed, they probably kill the SF and the Bristleback. And then, sure, even if they lose 4, killing 2 of the cores, it's not that terrible, but just dumping absolutely everything on the Bristleback in that position suggests that they thought he was quite alone, and he just wasn't.
Yeah. Well, that's the thing. They swept through the jungle. They made that move. They're like, okay, there's no one here, no one here, no one here. Bristleback's standing here, so you kind of assume that they're going to be hiding behind the towers. They're going to try and split push you out or something like that. But it just wasn't the case. newb.m. TPing in, moving everyone into one position. Then they've got the mech on Bristleback, which made that fight a lot harder for VG.P. Living armor, sure, they've got some sustain of their own. It's just not up to par with the mobility and disables from newb.m. Like, what disables do you have over on the Radiant? Charge and the lucky bashes? Whoa, AM. taken out up on this top lane. That was a Doom into Storm Spread taking him out. But yeah, disables. What VGP, they've got Doom, which is a pseudo-disable. Overgrowth, which is an ultimate. Yeah, basically they have ultimates. Vortex, Charge, and Cask. You know, Vortex is the only reliable one there. Whereas Newbee.M, they've got two spells which can basically be mini Ravages with the Earth Spike and Boros Strike. Then they've got Yules. They've got the Slow from Bristleback's Goo. They've got quite a few nice little things there.
Yeah, it's. I think that what VGP need now is to kill the AM another like two or three times in a row. Just keep them down while they keep scaling. If they could do that, they could maybe turn the game. But if they leave the AM for another 5 to 10 minutes, he's gonna get a Manta Star. He's gonna get probably a BKB as well, or whatever else he wants on top of his Manta Star. And at that point, the game's gonna be out of reach for them because everyone else is already so strong. SF's like already there, Lion's already there, Bristleback's already there, Sand King's already there. It's just the anti-mage who needs one to two more items to make him a little bit tankier.
Do you even consider going BKB on the Shadow Fiend right now? He's sitting on 3.2k gold. I kind of feel you just go straight into the Skadi and tank yourself up.
I think you're right. But look at Witch Doctor doing that MMY build, picking up the Midas. So it's actually three Midases now on the Radiant side. And maybe that's their plan to just... I mean, certainly if they do kill the Anti-Mage, as I was saying, if they manage to kill the Anti-Mage once or twice more in quick succession, having all these Midases is really going to give them like an advantage because they're keeping scaling while they're making kills. And they're going to smoke to that top lane. It's just two supports and an Anti-Mage. This could be a really good fight for VGP.
Yeah, now that tier 1 is gone, Storm Sprint zips across. Not going to find AM just yet. They will, though, as he's TPing out. The charge gave him the vision. Doom down onto him. But Epicenter, who's it going to land on? Seeker and Dogfight both getting dropped low. The sentry's placed to give them vision. But AM's already dead. Sand King now taking the right clicks like a boss. But he does get the kill on Treant with the Sandstorm in the end. 2-for-1.
Yeah, still very good for VGP. It's like fundamentally what they need to be happening. Shadow Fiend's still pushing on the bot lane, so it's not like the absolute end of the world for Newbee.M, that trade-off. But it's exactly the kind of trade-off that VG are looking for at this point in time. What do you think Spirit Breaker's gonna build into? He's got like 2.5k with his next Midas proc.
BKB wouldn't be bad. They've got the Urn over in Witch Doctor, and that's usually an early game item for the Spirit Breaker. Could go into a Halberd here. But I'm not too sure.
BKB makes sense to me with the... They're taking a lot of damage from Requiem and Shadow Rays, plus the Sand King and Lion spells. So I think frontlining with BKB makes a lot of sense. Oh, he's going Shadow Blade.
Nice.
And that is actually his preferred build. We've seen him do that in the past. And he's going to have the whole thing now, even though he's about to die. He's bought it, at least.
Did he go in for a kill there?
No, he just charged some creeps. He charged the creeps and like the Sand King and SF were standing right there and he charged creeps in front of them. Like he couldn't see them, they were in fog, but they were looking at the same creeps he charged onto.
Well, Triple S's Storm Spirit has 10 charges on the Bloodstone and he's making his way across that Orchid. One of the Oblivion Staves done and done, while Vanguard is the item that Bristleback goes back for. They'll smoke it to Roche with the DD on the Shadow Fiend. This should be pretty easy.
Yeah, and if Anti-Mage gets an Aegis, that's going to really, really disrupt the plan from VG.Game Potential. Because they need to be keeping him down. Unless he decides to like go fight a lot and die multiple times, loses Aegis and still die.
Lion? Lion, what are you doing so deep? TPing out? So he actually goes back to the tier 1. Putting himself in still a decent position to react to this fight. Smoke. And the Nature's Guys being popped by Treant there onto multiple heroes, just building up their invis, but this Dire Observer Ward is seeing out of everything. The Eye of Sauron basically there. They're scouting out every move that VGP make.
The plan for Newbee Miracle should be pretty straightforward now, just like Anti-Mage's Aegis, just let him farm at least Tormentor style, and like avoid anything too catastrophic happening in the meantime. And once Anti-Mage has that item, or maybe the next two items, then we go back to fighting and abusing the advantage we have.
Yeah, Anti-Mage with Aegis Immortal, he can start split pushing pretty hard. The top tier 1 is probably going to be where he aims for. I don't really feel team fighting is his forte right now with Battle Fury Vlads. It's all about the split push. Taking down towers, farming as efficiently as you can, pushing out wave and heading into the jungle and ancients, as this anti-mage is going to be pretty good. But he does actually go into the Radiant jungle, feeling that the VGP guys are hiding away. Oh, okay. They actually have vision. They've got vision in their own jungle with that observer ward spotting out every move they make. So obviously it is safer over in the Radiant.
Yeah, the concern I have is that when they have been team fights or like posturing for team fights, the anti-mage is often going there. And I think he's wasting his time doing that kind of thing. As you say, he's not really built to fight at the moment, even though he does have that Aegis. And the more time he spends not farming, the more value he gives to the triple Midas on the other side. And then there's that chance. I mean, it's not obvious. I don't know, is it obvious to you that the dire side wins when the game goes very late? It's not obvious to me at all.
No.
I think it could certainly go either way. In fact, the dire side wants to win when anti-mage is peaking, which means they want to get him into his peak sooner rather than later. And his peak starts when he gets Manta style.
Oh, that's the thing, you've also got this tri-core lineup from Newbee Miracle. You know, Bristleback, Shadow Fiend, and Anti-Mage, Epicenter from Sand King down at bot lane. The two-man stun down onto Yang and James, and that'll bring him down with the Sandstorm. With the Mana Void, they'll finish off that Spirit Breaker. That's a pretty nice little move there from Newbee Miracle.
A beautiful bait, actually, showing the lion, and so leading VG Gaming Potential to think it's an anti-mage covered by a lion, but actually they were both the baits. It wasn't just the anti-mage being covered by the lion, it was the anti-mage and the lion being covered by the Sand King.
But yeah, the tri-core lineup of Newbee Miracle is basically against, I want to say, a duo core here. Spirit Breaker, I don't really feel, is in a position to... Oh, AGK jumped and doomed. The Burrow Strike again with the Earth Spike across two Hex now. Where is it? Onto Lion, waiting for it, perfectly timed. Chained and stunned up as they take another couple of heroes. The Storm buys back. Zips forward. Is he TPing out? No, he's looking for the kill onto Lion as he makes his way back to the base. But Tier 3 is dead.
Yeah, and Doom can't buy back, and maybe all I was saying about needing more farm is wrong. Maybe they're actually strong enough right now to get Raxes.
Kind of interesting. Bristleback is tanking as all hell. Storm Sprint. Yang charging in with the Shadow Blade. He'll get the bash down to AM and the stun onto Sand King, but what do they make of this? Overgrowth catches two. Shadow Fiend. Requiem. Looks fancy, but doesn't do that much. Dogfight is going to be the one to fall as the anti-mage taken down by the Storm Spirit over to the left.
He's going to respawn with ulti. He could blink kill Storm maybe.
Oh man.
Is he going
to
He's
not going to go for it. Rax are more important. James the Witch Doctor trying to do his best he can. But right now, it's a 2-3 situation with the three being anti-mage and Bristleback. Okay, Storm. Storm, you're going to die this time, aren't you? Mana Void to finish him off. 44 seconds on the sidelines as Doom just respawned. Cold Snap is out of mana, but he's still going to work on these Raxes. James, stunned, in the Sandstorm, a few more right clicks, and the Urn Charge will take him down.
And here's Anti-Mage's Manta style. So, I guess, yeah, sensing that... Well, it's mostly after that kill, after that double kill, right, with the Sand King ulti. They found an opening to push. Not sure the intention would have been to go for Raxes right then if they hadn't done that. But seizing the opportunity and getting the first side of Raxes before the anti-mage even gets his Manta style.
Yeah, very nice indeed for Newbee Miracle. They've taken that 2,500 lead to about 10,000 over the past 3 minutes or so, 2.5 minutes, while Crimson Guard is done for the Bristleback. So now AM is hitting his peak. They want these sort of defensive but aggressive items. You know, they're defensive items, but in this context, they're using them to be aggressive. The Crimson Guard just allows him to walk up onto high ground with the mech on the bristle as well. He's got Sand, so he can be that frontliner and not really worry too much. Maybe try and bait the Doom or an Orchid or a Vortex from the Storm Spirit. While Anti-Mage, Shadow Fiend, they can position themselves at the back, blinking with BKB, Requiem down onto someone in the middle of the fight.
Yeah, they're all very tanky actually with the Crimson Guard mech and Vlads when they push this 5. Adds up actually to a whole lot of tankiness on the side of Newbee.M.
There's too many newbies.
No.
Too many newbies. Secret. Plate mail for him. Shiva's probably going to be the item of choice as Yang has gone back into the Ogre Club. So more likely than not going to be a BKB here as they get a smoke and it looks like they want to try and push out of their base and maybe find a pickoff. Stem the flow here from Newbee Miracle because they're building up momentum and it doesn't look like it's going to stop anytime soon. Or is this to go and find Roshan? No, Roshan doesn't respawn. We don't find out if he respawns for another couple of minutes. They've got the charge onto Cold Snap. They've got to doom him, though. The Bristleback goes down to half HP. The right-click attacks from Yang are doing a decent job. But this expenditure for a bristleback, okay, he doesn't have buyback or anything like that, and the Doom just keeps on going with secret staying in range.
Because he's alone, there's no response, and there's also no objectives to trade off, actually. So I think it's reasonable to use the Doom there. I don't think they're going to be made to pay for it at all.
Finally. Finally, Storm gets his Orchid, but who's his target? You can't go on the Shadow Fiend, can't go on the Anti-Mage. It's got to be for, you know, Lion or Sand King. Try and find them in the back end before they can get the Blink and Stun or Epicenter Blink. And actually, you 100% cannot go on the Shadow Fiend now. He finishes up a Lincoln's. I saw the Ultimate Orb and, you know, was 99% sure it was going to be a Scardy, with the 1% being, okay, maybe it's a Madness style, as they jump on the Lion with the Orchid, stunning him up, but Epicenter, pretty damn good here from the Sand King. Triple S has no mana left, and that just opens it up for Mana Void. Anti-Mage saying, thank you very much for that kill. And loses support for the Storm Spirit, who is the main team fighter here for VGP.
Yeah, and Bristleback's about to respawn. He's going to go there as quickly as he can. And can Storm buy back? No, he can't. He bought back previously. So if Bristleback gets there while Storm's still dead, that's enough to force at least the tower, I think.
Tier 2 up at top falls. Dogfights is still walking around in invis. He's got himself an Ogre Club, but I don't think that whatever item it is he wanted to go for is going to be finished anytime soon. Anti-Mage doomed up. Can they kill him though? They're staying in range. Death Ward is placed as well. Okay, Anti-Mage is dropping pretty damn low here as the Overgrowth comes out. Bow Strike available, but he's not using it. Can't get it off. And Newbee Miracle lose two heroes in quick succession with HEK trying to TP. Cold Snap going to take a hammering here in the middle of four heroes as he will drop. Shadow Fiend did get out of there. Lion respawns and he's sort of like, well, team, where are you guys? Why is there no one to TP to and help out?
Yeah, I think that Newbee.M was just not ready at all to be initiated on. They thought we're looking quite good here. We should just be able to like get this tower, get out. But initiation really well done there. Witch Doctor with a really good cask and ulti and Maledict. Combining with the Doombringer's Doom, making sure that the Anti-Mage goes down. Of course, the Doombringer standing nearby, meaning the Doom duration gets extended as well.
Pretty long Roshan respawn. I think this is something that Newbee Miracle are a little afraid of, that Roshan respawns quickly and then VGP head in. But what kind of vision have we got here? They see now the Witch Doctor heading over. They don't see the Treant, and they don't know where any of the cores are. Triple S is going to wait for the rune down at bot, but he can be pretty certain that, you know, Doom showed his face at top. They're not taking Roshan. There's no real chance of that. He'll respawn in a minute and 30 seconds, which gives time for Newbee.M to push out lanes, farm the jungle, farm their ancients, put a little bit of, you know, momentum and pressure down, especially, I think, mid lane, just so that VGP are forced to defend the tier 2 tower. They can head into Roche Pit.
Witch Doctor's got Aghanims. And Doombringer just picked up his BKB, which Spirit Breaker is about halfway to his BKB. I think BKB is very big right now. Based on the Shadow Fiend's build, there's a lot of his damage that's actually spell damage. I mean, because he's a Shadow Fiend, he's also obviously just got right clicks, but he's more spell heavy than the usual Shadow Fiend at this amount of farm and this amount of this time in the game.
Yeah.
Another thing that's relevant to that mid fight, by the way, the Anti-Mage had 5,000 gold when that happened, hadn't spent it yet. And he's going to have like an entire heart before the next fight, which...
Holy crap.
Definitely going to change the dynamic of the fight.
That's going to be difficult to deal with indeed. The smoke up from VGP heading up the ramp and looking for Cold Snap. Charges down onto him, but Storm Spirit says hello, goodbye to the Lion, as now Bristleback doomed up and dead. The Requiem not doing too much. Held in place by the Overgrowth and he can't escape. The right-click attacks now as the Sand King finally enters the fight, but his Epicenter is absolutely worthless. Dropping a couple of heroes low, but it's only the supports. That's four heroes dead. Anti-Mage is the last one standing. Heads back into the jungle and says, right, guys, I'm going to go and split push farm to head up to top lane. Roshan respawns in about 5 seconds' time. James, please stay in this pit.
That's how big that Doomringer BKB is, I think. And now Spirit Breaks is going to have one too. And Storm Spirit as well, all three of them. But just notice the Doom ramping in with a BKB. What is that? What exactly is meant to kill him? Like, it's only the Anti-Mage, really. Like, the SF's got some physical damage. Sand King Lion's got nothing. Bristleback doesn't really have a DPS build, similar to the SF, and Anti-Mage wasn't there. So, these BKBs are going to do an incredible amount of work for VGGame Potential, and I'm actually, even though they're still behind in Golden XP, I think I'm ready to say that
they're winning.
Favored in a fight now. Yeah, they're winning, maybe.
Again, it's one of those situations where they're behind, but they're looking to get ahead. They're in a position where they can definitely bring it back. And in fact, looking at the net worth graph right now, the 12k lead that newb.miracle had has been cut by 10k. That drops to about 2,000. 2 or 3k now, while the experience difference goes past zero. And VGP are now in the lead.
I mean, what's newbie's plan for while the enemy cores are all BKB'd? Like, do they try just run away and wait out the BKBs? Is there a conceivable way that they could win a fight through the BKBs? Do they have to try catch someone before BKB? Or maybe that's it. Maybe Lion or Sand King needs to blink on someone before BKB.
Get the chance. Charge comes in. Yang actually bashes up two. The two supports. The most important heroes. One gets obliterated instantly as Sand King is up on the cliff. Anti-Mage tries to get in there to do as much damage as he can, but he's dealing with BKBs. His mana break does nothing. He can't void anyone. The Requiem and Epicenter trying to do as much as it can, but Secret still piling in the heroes here. Taking down two, but Triple S. Mana Void's on cooldown, fortunately for him. Who's got Aegis the Immortal? Who's picked that one up?
Anti-Mage.
Burrow Strike? Okay. Storm Spread's so dead with no buyback.
The interesting thing in that fight is, like, I still firmly believe that there's no good way to deal with the BKBs for newbie, but the BKB usages amounted to not really that much because they were just trying to go on supports. You know, they killed the Lion and the Bristleback, that's what they got done with their BKBs. But it's the Anti-Mage and the SF they need to worry about. Those are the heroes they need to kill during their BKBs, I think.
Yeah, I guess the first fight it was so disjointed, you doomed up the Bristleback and he was forced to run away, you killed off the Lion, and there was just, you know, so much movement sort of starting in one central position and then spreading out, because newbee.m were the ones retreating, and that's what allowed VGP, you know, to pick one, pick another, and then just sort of roll with it. Whereas this fight around the Roche Pit, sure, it started in the Roche Pit and newbee.m spread out, but in two directions. Not into, you know, five directions scattering into the wind. Also, they weren't spreading out to retreat. They were spreading out to actually face up and fight against VGP. So even with the BKBs and the fact that they killed Lion back here, Sand King got in a good position up on the cliff and couldn't be focused down. And newbee.m, Shadow Fiend, and Anti-Mage, like you said, pretty much untouched in the team fight and managed to get a lot of their damage out.
This Sand King, he bought an ultimate orb, then he bought an ogre club, and now he bought a gem. Is that like some weird new recipe I don't know about? I guess changing his mind a lot. I guess ultimate orb, he was like going for Hex or Lincoln's.
He started off with ogre club. So
then he gets the ogre club to decide, I actually need BKB after what happened. And then the gem, because I guess his team just needs the gem.
Yeah. I need stats, guys. What are the best stat items I can get for the item slots I have here? Anti-Mage.
I mean, the ultimate orb is misplaced, though, given, you know, he'll probably regret having bought the ultimate orb once he decided to go for the BKB.
Yeah. Anti-Mage does lose just the multiple up on top lane. It took a good 4 or 5 man rotation in as they all TP out when he respawns, heading back to defend bot lane. Now, Witch Doctor. He's 200 experience away from level 16. If he gets that level 3 ulti out with that Aghanim Scepter, newbee.miracle could be in a world of hurt here if they try and push up onto high ground. Doesn't look like he's going to get that opportunity, though. As the push comes in pretty thick and fast, they go onto the Anti-Mage, the blink forward from Lion. Doesn't find the Storm Spirit. And Secret is waiting for his time to strike. Lincoln's is available in 3 seconds time now. The charge comes in, they cash AM, but again, it's just deterrent, stopping them from taking the tier 3 with ease.
Yeah, the Witch Doctor actually went bot, farmed a whole wave of creeps, but because their Axe creeps didn't give him enough XP to get his level 16.
He's so close! 36 experience, come on, you just take it! The stun goes out, a Storm Spirit zip zap! Forward and back. Anti-Mage and Bristleback, stun stop, but here's the stun, Death Ward's placed, he did hit level 16, that's a level 3 ulti, but the Blink Hex from 5400 will stop it in his tracks, as now Overgrowth, Yang, battling through it all, the Requiem again does nothing to these BKB targets, it slows and debuffs, but damage-wise, nil, Anti-Mage dead with a Doom, and Sand King will fall shortly after, one hero Running back, the Shadow Fiend escaping as Lion actually managed to TP himself out somehow.
Shadow Fiend needs to buy something which gives him physical right-click damage. Got to that point where the amount of farm he has, he's still second in the net worth. But the fact that BKB is countering more than half of his damage is just not acceptable.
It's not acceptable.
Yeah, I can't accept it. He shouldn't be willing to accept it. He needs to realize he's a strong independent Shadow Fiend and he doesn't need that spell damage.
That's something I've talked about with a lot of people, this utility Shadow Fiend build where you go the Yules, Blink, BKB, or you go the Mech Yules, Blink, you know, that's three item slots dedicated to utility and relative defensiveness. Sure, it gives you offensive capabilities where you can insta-kill someone with Yules Requiem, you can heal up your team as you're pushing into towers, but once it hits, you know, 35, 40 minutes, somewhere along those lines, there are other heroes who have bypassed the utility and they went straight for damage. Maybe they lost the early game, but if they can start winning teamfights in the mid to late game, that's where their build starts to peak. That's when they can pick up momentum and really start turning things around on you. But AGK, you don't want to sell any of these items either. It's got to the stage where you need Blink, you need BKB. Lincoln's is a necessity up against, you know, Charge, Vortex, Doom. I'm going to leave Doom to last because I feel that's the most important one. Yeah. Just going to put the emphasis on that. But now he's picking up the Butterfly.
Maybe the Yules could be replaced after Butterfly. I think at this stage, maybe not as important. But yeah, the dynamic of this game is really dictated by the fact that there were three Midases on the Radiant side. Triple Midas, so as long as the game's not going too badly for them, they're going to catch up and even overtake the farming of the Dire side. And all of that massive lead that was had by Newbee.M early on, all it took was, you know, one fight to equalize it, and that's largely on the basis that VG.Game Potential weren't as far behind as they would have been if they didn't go for those Midases. You know, you get the Midases and you just try and make sure that things don't go too badly, and when you find your opening, suddenly you're really strong.
Yeah, now they've got a pretty hefty experience lead for VG.P. It's not that important this stage in the game. You know, early on you're looking at when people are hitting level 6, level 11. At this stage, oh man, the smoke is smoke. Hex down onto triple S, the two-man first strike. Not going to hit the secret doom as he BKBs up. But now Death Ward, Overgrowth, bouncing between everyone. There's nothing to stop it. The Requiem is just going to slow people down again. Epicenter does land onto 3 with a bow strike into trees. They'll find the Sand King as he TPs himself out. Over on the side though, charge onto no one. Charge onto the Bristleback, actually, as the Sand King does get out of there. Shadow Fiend limping away.
And now Treant's Protector actually dogfights has the Aghanim Scepter, so that's going to give them a whole lot of map control as well. And yeah, things are rightly turning in VG.Game Potential's favor. I mean, they started going ahead earlier and then had a bit of a hiccup, but it feels like they really are seizing that lead now.
I made the mistake of saying Treant would never finish the item that he wanted to with an Ogre Club, and now he's got a full Aghanim Scepter. The reverse caster's curse.
Yeah, it's just how well things have gone for VG.Game Potential in the last 10-15 minutes. And yeah, look at that. Doombringer has actually overtaken Anti-Mage and Shadow Fiend in net worth now. The first time in basically the entire game. It's been AM and SF at the top the entire time. The Doom's now overtaken, the Storm's close to overtaking, and both Spirit Break and Witch Doctor have overtaken Bristleback.
Oh, what does the Doom go next though? He's got the Midas to sell, he could go for a Refresher here, but does he think along the same lines as the Shadow Fiend? Do I need more physical damage, or do I just go for the double Doom? Because if I can Doom Anti-Mage and Bristleback, that's the team fight pretty much won. Because not only are they going to be silenced and doomed up, but they kind of have to split themselves. You know, they've got to go in opposite directions. So if Doom chases one, you know, the duration stays and he keeps the Doom ticking. But if they both run together and retreat in the same, down the same route, that means they both can have Doom still ticking over on them.
I kind of like an AC, just because, I mean, they've already got Shivas. In fact, Storm is picking up one. They're going to have two Shivas now, which is kind of interesting. But I like an AC on Doom because we've already said there's a problem on Newbee.M dealing physical damage. And if you end up having an AC and a Shivas, that problem is going to be intensified massively. What's the Sand King done? He's actually put his Ogre Club back in his stash. I don't know what's going on.
Where's the gem? Well, whatever happened to that gem he had? It's gone over to James, actually. James has the gem. Is that
you know when
his?
The support witch doctors outfarmed the offlane bristleback? Yeah, I don't know. That's a sign of the times. I think that Newbee.M need to quite emphatically win this fight.
Land the star before the doom! BKB's down now.
Yeah, I don't know if this is enough for Newbee.M to force things. But it looks like VG.Game Potential thinking it might be. Oh wow, look at that. Trient's using his ulti with the Aghanims to just delay the chase as they all run away. And I guess the plan will be now to start eating all these trees up. Or do they just leave them?
How do you take him out though? You actually don't have a hero that can clear trees. You know, sometimes we see Batrider, Timber Sword, Storm Spirit, but there's no one.
Someone could buy a Quelling Blade. I mean, it's worth it. They can see all of these trees. They've got like sentry wards at all the places where they are. But there we go.
Oh, Quelling Blade. Has a Quelling Blade. Kind of interesting there when the sentry was placed. The creeps actually aggro to it.
Yeah, even though they can't attack it, they just like show that they can see it.
Yeah, it's like, hey guys, look at that over there. It's a shiny green thing in the tree. Let's see what it is. And then they realize, nah, it's none of our business. Leave it alone. Let's leave the heroes to do that.
So that's, I mean, Newbee.M hanging on there purely because the Doombringer blew his BKB, blew his Scorched Earth, and didn't manage to get the Doom off. So feeling the need to retreat. That's not going to happen every fight. Oh, there's the AC. It's on the Spirit Break, actually. So, Doomringer might very well go for that Refresh Orb then.
Another late respawn here for Roshan. He pops his head up now as Bristleback heads in and will scout it out. But VGP, they're ready. They're ready to contest this. Vision-wise, they've got this tree. The Eye in the Forest. They've actually got, you know, a whole bunch of them. So they'll see where the movement is coming in. The ones over on the side though have been taken out. Blink's in now. As Bristleback heads in, they know exactly what's going on. If Bristle hadn't walked in there, it'd be fine. Secret jumps in. Doom down onto who? Doesn't look like he's going to put on anyone except the Anti-Mage now. Epicenter will come in. Bow Strike not landing on anyone. The Overgrowth and Death Ward on the high ground. Bouncing between them all. They'll take this fight. It looks like it's going to be almost a wipe. As Shadowfin is still stuck on the cliff. AM is brought back. But where does he go? Who does he deal with? There's no one left as Cold Snap comes back to life and loses it straight away. As VGP, did they even lose anyone there?
Nope. They lost nobody.
Shit. 8,800 experience change. About an 8,000 gold swing as well as Newbee.M. That net worth lead, holy crap. From 14 to 14k over about 20 minutes. That is one big old swing as VGP now taking a pretty massive lead. Experience wise, same story.
This is just GG. Look at the Anti-Mage. He bought back and he hasn't left the fountain yet. He's just standing there.
Where can he go?
Like I guess he could buy a TP scroll, go split, push a lay and come back when he needs to. I don't know. Well, maybe you're right. Maybe there's nothing to do, so just buying back and standing around.
I think he sort of bought back thinking Shadowfiend and Bristleback would survive a little bit longer with Aegis Immortal and them being quite tanky. But they just couldn't.
Well, the Doombringer is not there. He's sending his Refresher. He can TP in soon though. But I think, yeah, Doombringer is going to have two Dooms in 15 seconds. And I think that VG.Game Potential just take another fight and then that's the game. I don't know if they even need to fully retreat. They could just fake back a bit and go straight back in.
Really? Witch Doctor has a BKB coming on the courier. This Witch Doctor is pretty freaking fat right now. 40 to 30, 48 minutes in, guys, for those of you just joining us. This is VG Potential against Newbee Miracle. Newbee's third team here. It's a bunch of old for love international players in the here in the VP game group stage qualifiers. So far, VGP took the first game. This is game number two, so Newbee.M, get jumped on now. BKB's popped by AGK, and Storm Spread just goes ham onto 5400. Lion is down and out for the count. Cannot turn around and do too much as the Death Ward back off cooldown, bouncing between everybody. GG is called. James with a Witch Doctor, pumping out the damage, and Anti-Mage doomed up, dead and dead. As the secondary Doom gets popped by the Lincolns. And game number two going the way of VGP.
But much more interesting one though, because this is a game where Newbee.M were 12,000 gold ahead at a stage, and the enemy team had a bunch of Midases, and Newbee.M with pushing heroes, pushing items with the Crimson Guard and the mechanism, and just failing to sort of close out the game when they had that window, and then the game turning around massively when those BKBs went up on VG.Game Potential.
Yes, indeedy. So that's it for this series, guys. 2-0 here. We have another game coming up shortly, but actually, I say shortly. In about an hour's time, there is a small hour's break for the guys over in China to get their dinner and have a little bit of a rest. So we'll be back in an hour with Terrorblade against Braveheart here in the VP game. Group stage qualifiers. Go and get yourself some lunch, some breakfast, some dinner, whatever you want to eat, have a drink. Go outside, have a jog. I'm not too sure what you guys enjoy doing, but hopefully you guys are having a good time. We'll see you guys in an hour.